example of what the scientist tells us is a world environmental crisis, almost not talked about at all. Or when it was talked about, well, there's a debate. He thinks it's real, he thinks it's not real. Mm-hmm. What do you think? There is no debate. All right, issue number one. Here's another issue, huge issue. You all know who the Koch brothers are? Tell me, and I need help on this one. If you have read an article or seen something on TV which tells you what the Koch brothers actually stand for, what do the Koch brothers want? What's their agenda? Anyone know?
Make themselves richer.
Power.
All right. The answer is the Koch brothers will spend over $900 million in this election. That is more money than either the Democratic Party or the Republican Party will spend. We don't know exactly what their agenda is, but we have a pretty good idea. In 1980, David Koch ran for Vice President of the United States on the Libertarian Party ticket. This is what his agenda was. Eliminate, end Social Security, end Medicare, end Medicaid, end the U.S. Postal Service, end the Environmental Protection Agency, end nutrition programs, end public education in America. Now, that was 35 years ago. Have they changed their views? Maybe, but I don't know that they have. So the point is, you have the second wealthiest family in America spending more money than the Democrats and Republicans, basically on an agenda that will end every program passed in the last 75 years to help working people. Have you seen that article in the papers yet?
Nope.
Okay.
But it's on Facebook.
Yeah. Yeah, it will get out in the alternative media. But it is not discussed terribly much. And that's what Citizens United has done. So what I am trying to do in this campaign, primarily, is to focus on those issues that mean the most to working families. And what are those issues? First of all, we have to realize that while the economy today, and I know Bobby Jindal will take credit for it, every Republican will take credit, the economy today is much better than it was when Bush left office. The fact is that the average American today is working longer hours for lower wages than was the case 30 or 40 years ago. All right?
Maternity leave, please.
All right. That's one thing. So how does it happen that in the richest country in the history of the world, the average person is working longer hours for low wages? We don't have to answer it, but that is the question we should be debating as a nation. If I give you a tool and new technology and you're producing more, why are you earning less? Is that a good question? Okay. Why is it in the United States we have the highest rate of child poverty of any major country on earth? 20% of our kids are living in poverty. Why do we have more income and wealth inequality? Want to hear inequality? The top 0.1%, 0.1% owns as much wealth as the bottom 90%. 56% of all new income is going to the top 1% today. Is that an issue you think we might want to be discussing?
Yes.
What about corporations stashing their money in the Cayman Island and not paying any taxes? That an issue? All right, other issues. When we talk about people not knowing, what people don't know is what other countries have achieved. All right? You talk about family, you talk about a family and medical leave. How many countries are major countries in the world do not provide paid family and medical leave when you have a baby? Major countries? None. Those are little small countries. So in America, you tell me, a woman has a baby who doesn't have a whole lot of money, how soon does she have to get back to work?
4 weeks.
Okay, so it could be 5 days. All right, we're the only country in the world that doesn't provide paid family and medical leave. How many major countries on earth do not provide health care to all of their people as a right? Anyone know? It's one. You're evident in it. You should know that.